Hey, what's up? It's Sifu Kuttel, and in this video, I want to show you how to do a technique that I used in one of my cutting videos. I think this is a great technique, especially when you have very curved swords, like this Yuan Dao by Chen. This is the Mongolian Saber, but you can do it with pretty much any single-edged sword or any Dao, okay? So this is quite a simple technique. We're doing an outward cut. So you can simply just think of taking the saber, resting it on your opposite shoulder, and then cutting straight across. Now, this is something that even when you watch the video, you don't see quite that's apparent in it. You usually just see my guard hand come through, or I continue through to a continuous cutting position. But really, it's hidden, the true secret to this technique. And I have to be honest, it even surprised me when I went through the cutting session because I put more attention into my guard hand, and this is what really makes the difference. We're applying leverage here, okay? So we're using our arm kind of like a seesaw. So not only are we bringing the blade around with this arm, with our sword hand, but we're adding a new fulcrum to it and pressing in a straight line. So now this push is giving an extra send-off into our cut, okay? So typically we do this wrapping the body, wrapping the head, and then it come down off the shoulder. So our cut doesn't have to be perfectly flat and across. It can be if you want, you just raise the hand up, or we can come a little bit downward here, cutting towards the throat and down. It's up to you, okay? So what we're gonna do is just place it on our shoulder and then put our hand on the inside, okay? So now my left hand is pushing on the spine of the sword. And then now I'm gonna basically push forward. Okay, get used to that. Just put your hand here and then push forward. I'm not doing anything with my sword hand other than letting the wrist move. This is the motion that you want. This is the feeling that you want. It's not my hand that's pushing on it. It's down at the wrist. Okay, so now I can cross the blade perpendicular as well. Okay, so now wrist is touching and then I'm gonna start pushing forward at the same time I'm gonna start bringing the blade out for the cut, okay? Now it seems quite simple, but I would suggest take your time, reset, put the arm inside, push. And then keep the hand up because this tends to keep our arm in a more of a perpendicular position to the blade rather than letting it get sloppy. And it also keeps our hand from letting those fingers sink forward and getting in the way of our blade, okay? So we need to have good position with the hand here. And then the rest of it is I want to draw the blade across. So I am going to have some reach just with my wrist, just with my cutting hand, but also I'm adding a quick snap of power into this. Now, typically what we do after this is we'll let the blade carry over. Once we've passed through our target, I'll let the hand turn over, rest it against the back, and then I'll wrap the head. Practice this only if you know how to do it. I have some videos you can look up back scratchers is a really good drill to get used to wrapping the head. But from here, we can turn it basically into a continuous cutting technique, okay? Now, the only thing that I would suggest on this one that you need to pay attention to is you have to control the blade as it's cutting. You can even see right here when I'm stopping it, I'm having some wobble. Once you add this extra energy from the forearm, you have a chance of letting it go wild. So you may lose a little bit of precision in your cuts at first while you're doing this, but the more you practice and the more you get used to flinging this hand out and clearing your target, you will actually be able to develop that accuracy back and you get an added amount of power, okay? So that's all I'm gonna say about this technique. I hope you enjoy it. Practice 1,000 times in the air before you even try to use this for cutting. Once you have a live blade moving around, you have to be very careful and very sure of your technique. This is not something you test out while learning, okay? Be safe, have fun, and I'll see you in the next video.